carefully. Your next cross will be to know some aspects, such as lacuna vasorum, place for arteria femoralis and vena femoralis, lacuna vasorum, and lacuna musculorum. These two lacuna is separated by the means of here, ligamentum inguinale, and in between must be a here, magnify, da, zoom. Arcus iliopectineus. Your combat mission, my dear, to write down walls, boundaries, frontiers of lacuna vasorum, once more. You must, how to show, you must find vessels and put pincers. Lacuna vasorum and lacuna musculorum. Moreover, it is of an important surgical role. Why? Because this place, which is bounded by ligamentum inguinale, ligamentum reflexum, ligamentum lacunare and vena femoralis, this is nothing else but annulus femoralis profundus, closed by lymph node. You will be asked about canalis femoralis, so-called femoral channel. You must strictly understand that it does not exist. It never exists under the normal circumstances. In norm, it appears only during the hernia forming. Do you know what is hernia? H-E-R-N-I-A, hernia. Walls of this hernia will be two layers of fascia lata, ligamentum inguinale, and annulus femoralis profundus could be found here. Place of inflow of vena saphena magna. It will be hiatus saphenus. For this reason, my dear, canalis femoralis, annulus femoralis superficialis, annulus femoralis profundus are to know, to write down, to learn, by heart, by rote, by memory. Next, my dear, let's trace, let's follow the vascular bundle. So, my dear, what's the reason? The point is that arteria iliaca externa and vena iliaca externa are nothing else but direct continuation, direct origin of arteria femoralis and vena femoralis correspondingly. Just these above mentioned artery and veins passes below the ligamentum inguinale, they find itself in lacuna vasorum, and they immediately receive a name, arteria femoralis and vena femoralis. On the thigh, they lie, they are situated in sulcus iliopectineus, is bounded by musculus iliopsoas, here, small part of musculus iliopsoas, and musculus pectineus, this one, small part of musculus pectineus, and together it makes sulcus iliopectineus. After that, my dear, they are situated in sulcus femoralis. My dear, don't confuse this formation. It is not the same. Canalis femoralis, sulcus femoralis, and trigonum femorale will be mentioned further. Sulcus femoralis bounded by musculus vastus medialis and musculus adductor longus. Moreover, my dear, one can observe trigonum femorale. Look, 1, 2, 3. It's bounded by musculus sartorius, ligamentum inguinale, and musculus adductor longus. It will be trigonum femorale. This one. Trigonum femorale. Next, my dear. This vascular bundle moves further and penetrates so-called canalis adductorius. It's bounded by musculus vastus medialis, musculus adductor magnus, and lamina vasto adductoria. Let me see here, my dear. Look, small plate, small lamina, lamina vasto adductoria. After that, my dear, remember that, as you were told, each channel has inlet foramen and two outlet. Let's see. Inlet foramen and outlet foramen. If I show you, it will be great. But I will show you our body. No. Stand still. Next, my dear, you must know fossa popliteea. It is nothing else but, I put my fingers there. It is nothing else but place of next predestination of arteria and vena femoralis. But don't embrace. But just they find themselves in fossa popliteea. They are named arteria femorale, arteria popliteea, and vena popliteea. After that, these arteria and vena popliteea passes into the canalis cruropopliteus. My dear, mark it well. Please don't confuse. Canalis cruropopliteus is situated between superficial and deep muscles of leg. It cannot be found in no circumstances here between gastrocnemius and soleus. This is your false fellow friend. It is nervus cutaneus sure medialis. But canalis cruropopliteus is here. Each channel has, once more, three foramen. First, inlet. It will be nothing else but direct continuation of fossa popliteea. I will show you on that body. And two outlet foramen. First outlet foramen can be found between... Можно дуже тихо и зачиняйте двери с той стороны. Can be successfully found between muscular part of musculus triceps sure and tendinous part in inferior third of leg. This is your little prompt. This will be your little prompt. This string will help you. And anterior outlet foramen. Place of arising of some vessels here between musculus tibialis anterior and musculus extensor extensor digitorum longus. Come here quickly. We can see here look my dear musculus piriformis here apertura supra piriformis and apertura infra piriformis superiorly and inferiorly to the musculus piriformis. Next, my dear, we can observe also canalis obturatorius. Here, you can see nervus obturatorius, this one, nervus obturatorius, and it passes through the canalis obturatorius. Next. Arteria iliaca externa, vena iliaca externa, ligamentum inguinale, enthia ioa, lacuna vasorum. Laterally to the... Da, Sion, prasa. You are right, help me. Mm-hmm. Da. And laterally to the lacuna vasorum, we can see lacuna musculorum. Between lacuna vasorum and lacuna musculorum, we can see arcus iliopectineus. Here, once more, sulcus iliopectineus, sulcus femoralis, and look, my dear, canalis adductorius. This is plate. Lamina vasto adductoria. Three foramen, my dear, three orifices. Inlet foramen, this one, inlet foramen. Anterior outlet foramen, a little hint. Nervus saphenus arises from this foramen. Nervus saphenus, this is your hint. And next, hint in the cleft of musculus adductor magnus, here. This vascular bundle, arteria femoralis and vena femoralis. This is posterior outlet foramen. Next, my dear, I forgot to show. Look. The point is that musculus sartorius, tendo musculi gracilis, and tendo musculus semi tendinosus, where is here? Form, my dear, look, form. Pes anserinus superficialis. Meanwhile, tendo musculi semimembranosi forms pes anserinus profundus. Look, fossa poplitea is there. Fossa poplitea. Don't forget to write down walls. Canalis cruro popliteus, here. And this is your hint. Nerves, vessels. Look, inlet foramen starts from fossa poplitea. Inlet foramen and two outlet foramen between muscular part of musculus triceps sua here and tendinous part between tendo achille here. How to never confuse? You can feel pulsation of your vessels at the medial aspect of leg and anterior outlet foramen. Anterior outlet foramen between musculus tibialis anterior and musculus extensor digitorum longus. And this is your hint. Nervus peroneus profundus. This. I pierce this orifice intentionally. Don't forget, my dear, sulcus plantaris medialis, sulcus plantaris lateralis. And I forgot to show you. We can observe also canalis musculo peroneus. Canalis musculo peroneus longus. My dear, look. How to find it? Canalis musculo peroneus longus. You must find musculus fibularis or peroneus longus. Oi. Canalis musculo peroneus superior, this one. And you must find nervus peroneus communis. It passes. It could be found within the frame of this channel. Next. Canalis musculo peroneus inferior, I cannot show you. But hypothetically, it's situated between fibula and look. This is nothing else but musculus, flexor, hallucis, longus. And this channel is situated in between these two above-mentioned formations. Come here, I will show you this channel.
canalis musculo peroneus
superior. Here, my dear, here. It's necessary to find a musculus peroneus, longus, and this nerve, my dear, nervus peroneus superficialis, actually could be found below this muscle, between caput fibulae, column fibulae, and musculus peroneus longus. Понятно, my dear?
Да,
понятно. Great. You are brilliant. Let's go to the table.